गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। तो आज के क्लास में वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द बायोसिंथेसिस ऑफ फैटी एसिड्स। नाउ व्हाट आई हैव डन इज, इस चैप्टर को मैंने तीन भाग में बांट दिया है ताकि आप लोग को आसानी हो डाउनलोड करने में। नाउ बायोसिंथेसिस ऑफ फैटी एसिड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट for the human body as well as for the animal kingdom. So let us start this chapter one by one. Unsaturated fatty acid in phospholipid of the cell membrane are important in maintaining the membrane fluidity. A high ratio of PUFA to saturated fatty acids in the diet happens to be beneficial in preventing coronary heart diseases. Now, most of us have a very limited capacity of desaturating fatty acids, and we require certain dietary polyunsaturated fatty acids from the plants. This, what is known as essential fatty acids, they are used by the body to form the 20 carbon atom fatty acids or the eicosanoic fatty acids. These give rise subsequently to eicosanoids, prostaglandins, thromboxanes, leukotrienes and lipoxins. These prostaglandins are an important mediator of inflammation, pain, they induce sleep and also regulate blood coagulation and reproduction. The different non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, in short known as NSAIDs, such as aspirins and ibuprofen, they act, or their mode of action is by inhibiting this prostaglandin synthesis in the body. The leukotrienes have muscle contractant and chemotactic properties, and they are important in allergic reactions and inflammation. Now, so we start that the main pathway for the synthesis of fatty acid from scratch, शुरू से फैटी एसिड्स का सिंथेसिस जिसको वी कॉल एज लाइपोजेनेसिस, दे अकर इन द साइटोसोल। नाउ ये जो सिस्टम है, ये इन आवर बॉडी इज प्रेजेंट इन द लिवर, द किडनी, द ब्रेन, द लंग्स, मेमोरी ग्लैंड्स एंड ऑफ कोर्स द एडिपोज टिश्यूज। नाउ मेनी कोफैक्टर्स आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ लाइपोजेनेसिस। वो है NADPH, ATP, manganese ions, biotin and a bicarbonate which is a source of carbon dioxide. The acetyl coenzyme A happens to be the immediate substrate, and last the free palmitate is the end product. Now this production of malonyl coenzyme A in the process of lipogenesis happens to be the initial and controlling step in the fatty acid synthesis. That means ki isi step pe hum lipogenesis ke process ko control kar sakte hain. Now the bicarbonate, which happens to be the source of carbon dioxide, this is required for the initial reaction of carboxylation of acetyl coenzyme A to malonyl coenzyme A in the presence of ATP and the enzyme acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. Now, ye jo enzyme hai, acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase, this has a major role in the regulation of fatty acid synthesis, and The acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase, it requires the B vitamin biotin, and it happens to be basically a multi-enzyme protein. And this multi-enzyme protein, it contains biotin, biotin carboxylase, biotin carboxyl carrier protein, and a carboxyl transferase. And now, as well as there is a regulatory allosteric site for this multi-enzyme protein known as acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. Now, we will see that this step of production of malonyl coenzyme A, ये दो पार्ट में होता है. एक पार्ट में क्या होता है कि एसिटाइल कोएंजाइम ए से पहले बायोटिन को हम लोग कार्बोक्सिलेट करते हैं बाइकार्बोनेट आयन से. उसके बाद जब बायोटिन कार्बोक्सिलेटेड हो जाता है तो ये बायोटिन वो जो कार्बोक्सिल ग्रुप है उसको ट्रांसफर कर देती है एसिटाइल कोएंजाइम ए विद अ नेट रिजल्ट दैट अ मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ malonyl coenzyme A is formed. तो इसको elaborate करते हुए हम लोग आगे बढ़ते हैं. Now, this is a picture of this enzyme complex. So, you have an enzyme complex. This is the acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase enzyme complex. Now, as I told you, ये मल्टी एंजाइम कॉम्प्लेक्स है और इसमें दो एंजाइम है E1 एंड E2 विद अ बायोटिन कैरियर प्रोटीन इन द मिडल एंड अ कोवेलेंटली लिंक्ड मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ बायोटिन. ये जो E1 है दिस इज द एंजाइम बायोटिन कार्बोक्सिलेज और ये जो E2 है ये कार्बोक्सिल ट्रांसफरेज है. नाउ this reaction, as I said earlier, it proceeds in two steps. Pehla step mein kya hota hai, which is catalyzed by the E1 or the biotin carboxylase. Biotin is carboxylated as it accepts carbon dioxide group from the bicarbonate to form a carboxylated biotin. And in the next step, what happens is that this E2 acts on this carboxylated biotin on acetyl coenzyme A and it transfers the carbon dioxide group which is attached here to form a molecule of malonyl coenzyme A and the acetyl carboxylase enzyme complex is set free. Now, after the formation of malonyl coenzyme A, it meets a group of enzymes which is known as the fatty acid synthase complex. Now, this fatty acid synthase complex is basically a homodimer, that is same two polypeptide chain with the same number of amino acids or the same number of enzymes, and this homodimer of two polypeptide chain iske andar 6 enzymes hai aur ek acyl carrier protein hai. So kya hota hai कि आफ्टर मालोनिल कोएंजाइम ए के फॉर्मेशन के बाद द फैटी एसिड्स ये इसी एंजाइम सिंथेस कॉम्प्लेक्स के थ्रू जाके ये अंत में एक मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ पामिटेट बनाता है. नाउ ये जो इंडिविजुअल एंजाइम्स है 6 ये इस मल्टी एंजाइम पॉलीपेप्टाइड कॉम्प्लेक्स में ये एक दूसरे से अटैच्ड रहता है Or in this, there is also a vitamin pantothenic acid, which is in the form of 4' phosphopantothene. Let's look at the bigger picture. So you will see that the six enzymes that we have are ketoacyl synthase, malonyl acetyl transacylase, dehydratase, enol reductase, ketoacyl reductase, the acyl carrier protein, and lastly, the thioesterase. So you are saying it, the thioesterase is on this end of the X, malonyl acetyl transacylase is at this end of the X, and the ketoacyl synthetase, which starts this, is at the starting here. Now, what you are seeing here is a diagram which is showing you the production from acetyl coenzyme A straight away to the formation of palmitate. So, I will take you through this one by one. Now, each of these steps are designated 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1A and 1B. So, we will take this one by one and I will explain to you kaise acetyl coenzyme A molecule produces in the end a molecule of 16 carbon palmitate. तो शुरू में क्या होता है कि एक प्राइमिंग मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ एसिटाइल कोएंजाइम ए ये कंबाइन करता है 16 SH ग्रुप से. ये जो फर्स्ट होमोडाइमर का जो फर्स्ट पार्ट है उसमें 16 SH ग्रुप के साथ ये कंबाइन करके तो एसिटाइल कोएंजाइम ए कंबाइंस विद दिस इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ malonyl acetyl transacylase, and this acetyl coenzyme A, if you remember previously using acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase, has formed a molecule of malonyl coenzyme A. Now this malonyl coenzyme A, ye jo acetyl coenzyme A yahan attach ho gaya, aur ye jo pantothenic acid ke paas 4 prime phantothene ke SH group se this malonyl coenzyme A is attached here in reaction 1B. Now this reaction is catalyzed by malonyl acetyl transacetylase, and the compound form is acyl acetyl malonyl enzyme. क्योंकि ये एंजाइम के साथ अभी भी लगा हुआ है, एक एंजाइम के बाद दूसरे एंजाइम के बाद तीसरे, इट गोज ऑन वन बाय वन. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट द एसिटाइल ग्रुप ये दिस अटैक्स द मिथिलीन बॉन्ड ऑफ द मालोनिल रेसिड्यू, एंड व्हाट इट डज इट बाय द रिएक्शन इज कैटलाइज्ड बाय 3 ketoacyl synthase, और एक molecule of carbon dioxide ये liberated हो जाता है, and what is formed is known as 3 ketoacyl enzyme, also known as acetoacetyl enzyme, and in this process what happens is that ये जो 16 SH group के साथ जो attached था acetyl, ये इधर आ गया और ये 16 SH group is now free. Now what happens is that from the previous we see that the 3 ketoacyl enzyme isko what happens is that now it undergoes 3 processes. Ek reduction reaction 3, ek dehydration reaction 4, and again ek reduction reaction 5. So it is reduced, dehydrated and reduced again to form the corresponding saturated acyl enzyme, that is the product of reaction 5. So 3-ketoacyl reductase using NADPH forms 3-hydroxyacyl enzyme. Then there is dehydration, a molecule of H2O is released, and you have 2-3 unsaturated acyl enzymes at this point. Then again, using NADPH, the enzyme in oil reductase, it forms acyl enzyme. Now, what happens to this acyl enzyme? This acyl enzyme is recycled back again to the top, and it displaces, it is attached to the SH group of 4' phosphopentadiene, or ye saturated acyl group ko ye free jo cysteine SH group hai uske saath ye attach hota hai. So this as maronyl again comes here, and what happens is that ye jo pentadiene SH hai iske saath attach hai aur cysteine SH free ho jata hai. Now this sequence of reaction, ye jo hai 1A, 1B, 2, 3, 4, 5, again it goes back. This happens 6 more times to produce a 16 carbon acyl radical, which is known as palmitic acid. Now, once the palmitoyl or the 16 carbon acyl radical is formed, it is liberated from the enzyme complex by using the enzyme thioesterase or deacylase. So it releases a molecule of palmitate. So again, we come back to this. So what is happening? This acyl enzyme, it goes back again, and again this cysteine SH group, again it starts, the acetyl is attached here, it jumps here, and then it comes back. So you have another carbon molecule here. So what is happening is that using adding 2 carbon at a time, you have the formation of palmitate. Now, before using this palmitate, what happens is that body isko activate karta hai into acyl coenzyme A, aur activate hone ke baad hi it is proceeding dusre metabolic pathway mein jata hai. To iska kya use hai body mein? The possible fates are it can be esterified to form the acyl glycerols, that is the diacyl and the triacyl glycerols. The palmitate can be elongated to form long chain fatty acids, or it can be desaturated to form unsaturated fatty acids, or the palmitate can be esterified into cholesterol esters, that is esterification of this acyl group to a molecule of cholesterol to form an ester. Now, inside the mammary glands, there is a separate thioesterase which is specific for the acyl residues of 8 carbon, 10 carbon or 12 carbon acyl coenzymes A's. And these 8, 10 and 12 carbon, they are found particularly in the milk lipids. The acetyl coenzyme A that is used in the as a primer, this is found on the 15th and 16th carbon of the palmitate molecule, and all the other carbon, 2 carbon units, they all come from malonyl coenzyme A. Now, instead of malonyl coenzyme A, Sorry, instead of acetyl coenzyme A used as a primer, if we use a 3-carbon propanyl coenzyme A for the synthesis of long chain fatty acids, तो क्या होता है कि odd number of carbon atoms are found in the lipids. And this type, if you remember when we talked about the chemistry of lipids, is particularly found in the fat and milk of ruminants, that is the cows and the goats and the buffaloes. So they are the odd chain fatty acid. Now let us talk about a very important thing, that is NADPH. Now NADPH is completely different and a completely different role from NAD. Now we will see that for the production of each molecule of palmitate, the body has to supply 14 NADPH molecules, which acts as a reductant, that is a reducing agent. Now ये जो NADPH है जो use हो रहा है lipogenesis में, इसका main source होता है pentose phosphate pathway or the HMP shunt. So that is the main source of NADPH in our body. Now ये जो NADPH है, if you remember, it was involved in the reduction of 3-ketoacyl and 2-3 unsaturated acyl derivatives. और ये जो pentose phosphate pathway का जो oxidative pathway है, this is the chief source of hydrogen जो कि required होता है fatty acid synthesis में. I believe you have just been taught HMP shunt. So remember, HMP shunt is very important, not only for the supply of NADPH, but also for the supply of the pentose sugars, which are used in the production of RNA and DNA. So you have to remember this. And it is these NADPH that is produced in the HMP shunt, which is not only used for lipogenesis, but it is also involved in many of our antibacterial and our anti-inflammatory action of the body. Now we will see that jahan jahan active lipogenesis hota hai, jaise ki liver, the adipose tissue and the lactating mammary glands, wahi wahi it has been found that they have a very active HMP shunt pathway. Aur dono jo metabolic pathway hai, lipogenesis ka pathway aur HMP shunt ka pathway, they both are found inside the cytosol of the cell, taki इन दोनों को कोई मेम्ब्रेन बैरियर्स या कोई परमीएबिलिटी बैरियर नहीं है अगेंस्ट द ट्रांसफर ऑफ NADPH फ्रॉम HMP शंट टू द लाइपोजेनेसिस पाथवे. नाउ अपार्ट फ्रॉम NADPH, सॉरी अपार्ट फ्रॉम HMP शंट, द अदर सोर्सेस ऑफ NADPH आर द रिएक्शंस ऑफ व्हाट इज नोन एज द मैलिक एंजाइम, where the conversion of malate to pyruvate catalyzed by the NADP malate dehydrogenase produces NADPH, and also the extra mitochondrial isocitrate dehydrogenase reaction which also produces NADPH, but this is a substantial sources in the ruminant animals. So you will see that the malic enzyme, the oxaloacetate, is converted to malate in the cytosolic NADH dependent malate dehydrogenase. It requires a molecule of NADH plus H plus. Now this malate, under the presence of malate dehydrogenase enzyme, which requires NADP, it forms pyruvate. So this malic enzyme converts malate to pyruvate and produces the molecule of NADPH plus H plus, that is a reduced NADP. Now, this reduced NADP, as I've said, is used in the reductive biosynthesis of fatty acids, steroids, and the sterols, that is cholesterol. It is used in the cytochrome P450 system of our body to kill the bacteria and deconjugate and detoxify many of the toxins that we eat in our diet. And also, it detoxifies the reactive oxygen intermediates which are present inside the body. Now, let us look at this whole confusing picture that I have shown before you. So, what are we looking at? We are looking at where did the acetyl coenzyme A come from? So, this is acetyl coenzyme A. And where did the NADPH come from? So, let us take a look at this one by one. So, you have a molecule of acetyl coenzyme A. This is the starting molecule of lipogenesis. Now, this acetyl coenzyme A, under the influence of enzymes, it is forming malonyl-CoA. Now, malonyl-coenzyme A forms palmitate and requires NADPH as a reductant source. So, where does this NADPH come from? As I said, the malic enzyme converts malate to pyruvate and forms NADPH. This pyruvate, it enters inside the mitochondria and it, using the enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase, it forms a molecule of acetyl-CoA. Now, acetyl-CoA, there is no transporter for this. So, there is a tricarboxylic transporter. So, what happens? A molecule of acetyl coenzyme A combines with a molecule of oxaloacetate in the TCS cycle to form a molecule of citrate. Now, this citrate goes out through the tricarboxylic transporter in exchange for a molecule of malate. This citrate again undergoes cleavage to form a molecule of oxaloacetate and a molecule of acetyl coenzyme A. This oxaloacetate, as I said, forms malate. Malate forms malic enzymes. This malate can also come back inside the, using the tricarboxylic citrate the transporter. It can come inside. This malate can form oxaloacetate, producing NADH plus H, this oxaloacetate again forms citrate, acetyl coenzyme A. So, what we see here is that the starting molecule is glucose. Glucose ke breakdown se, gluconeogenesis se, pyruvate bana. Pyruvate mitochondria cross kiya. TCA cycle ko use karte huye, acetyl coenzyme A bana aur ye acetyl coenzyme A use hota hai in the production of palmitate. Now, with this, I end this first part of this fatty acid synthesis. Now, in the next part, we will talk about how acetyl coenzyme A starts this process of fatty acid synthesis, iska elongation kaise hota hai aur iska kaise hum log isko regulate karte hain, phir kaise unsaturated fatty acids banate hain. Now, dear students, I want all of you that you should, if you think you have a problem, please WhatsApp your message to your class representative with the subject heading, either lipids or carbohydrate or hormones, whatsoever, with your problem so that we can get back to you via WhatsApp. Also, I want each one of you to WhatsApp Shekhar ji, our senior technician in the department. Just WhatsApp your roll number. For example, roll number 23. All you have to do is, from your WhatsApp, you just write 23 and that is all. Send it. So I would like to know, are the students taking these classes? Is it useful to you? Or are we just wasting our time? Please do give a feedback if you have any problem through your class representative, both boy and girl. Okay, so now I will end this.